when you drive in, you get this feeling that's like overwhelmed with sadness every time I come here.
Wybalenna means black man's houses. And this is what remains of the settlement on a windswept corner of Flinders Island.
People need to know the real story that happened here at Wybalenna, how we were treated as a people.
134 men, women and children were rounded up on mainland Tasmania by colonial officials and exiled to Wybalenna in 1834. Most died of disease and neglect.
My grandfather mourned so much that he, in the end, cut all of his beautiful red locks. For him to cut his locks off, everything was gone. It represented everything he is. He just mourned himself to death.
This is Tasmania's largest known Aboriginal burial ground. 107 unmarked Aboriginal graves.
Yeah, there is an actual list over there to let you know who and how many.
The Commandant, George Robinson, lived in this white house on Wybalenna. He tasked two Aboriginal boys to write the settlement's newspaper. Robinson had tight editorial control, dictating lines to a 14-year-old Thomas Broon and 17-year-old Walter George Arthur. The Aboriginal, or Flinders Island Chronicle, as it was also known, was the first publication by Aboriginal Australians. And while not widely known, the story is one of resistance and of fighting to document the truth.
They were urged to write a chronicle. And if you read the text and read the lines between the text, you'll see how these black kids have been imposed on. Write these things about how good we white people are and how the white lord will look after your people. And it's all in these chronicles.
Over time, though, the boys managed to paint an honest picture of conditions. The brig Tamar arrived this morning. Let us hope it will bring good news and that something may be done for us poor people. They are dying away. Nothing but sickness among us. There was no printing press. The handwritten newspaper came out every Saturday on a sheet of foolscap. All up, there were 27 editions, and the newspaper ran for a year. Historians say the ultimate act of defiance came years later, when one of the boys, Walter Arthur, wrote a petition to Queen Victoria demanding the dismissal of the Commandant. It was the first ever petition to a reigning monarch by Aboriginal people. It worked. Wybalenna was closed.
Their story needs to be told. It's the very history of Tasmania.
Lil Wheatley was part of a group that occupied this site in the late 1990s. And eventually, Wybalenna was handed back to Aboriginal people. In 2023, volunteers came and restored the shearing shed on the site, which became an important meeting place.
A long, long time ago, my aunties first started coming here and doing fences around the graveyard, and it's been a long, long road, like 25 years. That's how long I've been involved, but we're now, you know, taking ownership of this place, of what it means. Yeah, still here and fighting. You will see us.